It's an exciting day for me today. I mean, going back to Egerton Park, where cricket sort of started for me, in the fact that I played regularly. That's where you got to bat, bowl, field in every position, and it was great fun. I do love nipping back there. It really is a family club. Great memories of it, and looking forward to seeing a lot of familiar faces today. Next left, I think it is, that we drive in. You could always tell when the cricket season was getting close. On a Saturday, there'd always be a football game going on the right-hand side here. And when the strikers missed a goal, you'd have to go and boot the ball back. It would come onto our field. It's not changed much, I must admit. My last game here must have been 2004. I'm looking forward to seeing inside the changing rooms, because see if they've improved. I don't think they've changed since the 70s.
Where is he? Sorry I'm late, mate.
Long way.
Good to see you.
Welcome.
Thank you. This is where it all started, was it?
It is where it all started, where it all began.
I was going to say, what age were you when you started?
Quick cricket age, so 7 or 8, I think, and carried all the way through to 17 into the first team.
Has it changed much?
We never had covers, that's for sure. It was sawdust, that's what we went for. And we didn't have the nets. So, yeah, there's been quite a lot of improvements.
Well, it was a beautiful ground. I got stuck the wrong side of the river as I came in, and there's another one there. Did you tell me you used that to your tactical advantage sometimes?
We did, yeah. We used to have a pinch-hitting opening batsman who used to try and hit their brand new ball into the river. You didn't get a new ball. We had a big fishing net. You get the ball out of the river, pour it out, dry it off a bit and throw it back. So the quicker you got the opposition's new ball into the river, the better you were.
Come and introduce me to the chairman, because I know he's an integral part of this club. Hi, David.
Hi, good afternoon. David Glover, chairman. Steve, good afternoon. Nice to see you again.
Let's go in, shall we?
Thank you very much. David, what are your memories of a young Stuart Broad here?
A young Stuart Broad?
Be good.
In the late 90s, early 2000s, a young Stuart Broad. Bit of an all-rounder, really, in the second team. Obviously, nowhere near as tall as he is now, you know. Little lad, used to bowl his 6 or 7 overs up and down, didn't you? I had him in the second team until June 2003, I think, and then his rapid rise to fame took off. I believe he got a 50 somewhere for the second team one day, and that's the last I saw of him as second team captain. He was in the first team, and on to much bigger and better things.
But you couldn't get the new ball out of his hand, could you?
Like left arm. Tried to bring the stumps into play.
Specifically around this area, I mean, the tables are all nicely set out, the bar's beautifully clean, but that doesn't clean itself, tables don't set themselves. What are the challenges of running a cricket club, and how dependent are you on people giving up their time freely?
You've got to rely very heavily on the committee and other members of the club just to give up their time and say, come and give us a few hours and help us do this.
So they don't give up their time, no club?
Absolutely, absolutely. They are the heartbeat of the club, and it's their unpaid help that keeps the club going.
You're a few years away from playing golf every day because you've still got some cricket to play, but do you fancy coming back?
Yeah, I mean, I try and get back a couple of seasons ago, come and watch when I can. I've still got friends who play here, and the great thing about Egerton, it's a family club. I mean, I remember growing up that I'd come off the field and then all the kids had gone and play just in front of the clubhouse, and the parents would be having a drink in here, but then watching there and playing. And it's a very sociable club. The people around the club make it the club it is. And I think even opposition teams like to come back here. Like whenever I see people around, I see people at Lords and Old Trafford who say, oh, I played against Edgerton, what a club that is, what a really nice club that is. When people enjoy coming here, then people will keep coming.
Lovely cosy little dressing room here. I mean, you've been in some of the biggest in the world, MCG, Lords, all that sort of stuff. But taking you back when you're a younger guy into this dressing room in the first team, playing cricket with grown men, it's quite an eye-opener, isn't it? You have to grow up pretty quick.
Yeah, this room is where sport almost got competitive for me, if you know what I mean. You play quick cricket and you're sort of just having fun learning your trade, but you step in as a 12, 14-year-old kid into an adult change room while you're playing for points on a Saturday. So this is where I heard my first sort of team talk of making sure we set the tone and all the stuff that still goes on to this day. So I'll always have great memories of this change room. Yeah, it's not the most glamorous of it. No, it has improved slightly. But yeah, this is where sport gave me that extra buzz of competitiveness, and that's certainly the buzz that I thrive off the most.
Well, as you do at a cricket ground, grab a brew, let's go for a walk around the boundary at this gorgeous cricket club. But it's not just about the players that turn out and play on a Saturday. There's a lot of people behind the scenes that have to give a lot of time to make it all happen.
Yeah, very much so. I mean, look at the wicket. You've got groundsmaster to prepare the wicket all week. Lovely outfit, all cut. You need a lot of people who love the club, who like coming down to help the club. A lot of it is giving up the time. You know, with cricket, it is a long hour game, isn't it? So you need people to give up their Saturdays. Here at Egerton Park, it was quite a famous place for the teas, because it's Melton Mowbray is the home of pork pies and Stilton cheese, and so our opening batsman never used to score a run after tea. But I think it's quite a behind-the-scenes job, isn't it? I think they deserve a huge amount of credit for what's in place at cricket grounds to let people enjoy not just playing, but also coming to watch as well.
And someone's also got to do the scoring. Somebody told me that you used to like scoring, is that right?
Yeah, I used to find it quite relaxing, yeah, making sure I had a really neat scorebook.
Looking ahead to this summer, we'll start with the test matches in Sri Lanka. I mean, the first two, Headingley and Durham, does that give England a big advantage with those conditions?
It should do. I mean, our actual results record at Headingley is not fantastic. Sri Lanka beat us in England last time, which hurt us a lot. They've got some dangerous players, so there'll be a lot of motivation to put that right.
Right, we're going to get wet. Should we go inside?
Yeah.
Okay, bye-bye. Stuart hung around for a Q&A with some of the club's members and friends and took part in a wine tasting that evening in an event organised to bring the club together before the start of the new season. The work of the volunteers behind the scenes, with a little help from Stuart, has got Egerton Park ready for this new season. Volunteers are the heartbeats of their clubs, and the same will be happening at many cricket clubs up and down the country, which is fantastic to see. Here's to another successful season.